The latest sci-fi action film, Code 8 Part 2, is making a thrilling impact. In this world, 4% of the population is born with superpowers, strictly controlled and limited to basic labor jobs with meager salaries. However, with the advancement of technology, most basic jobs are now performed by robots. As the unemployment rate among superpowered individuals rises, the national crime rate gradually increases. In the city of Lincoln, a new type of drug called SEC emerges. SEC's primary ingredient is the spinal fluid of superpowered individuals. To maintain security in Lincoln, the police force introduces mechanical police officers and deploys numerous drones for constant patrol. These police officers have automatic lethal functions and shoot anyone, whether human or superpowered, deemed dangerous. Due to the escalating number of casualties caused by the mechanical police, under pressure, the authorities replace them with robotic dogs. Apne and her brother Tarak live in a Lincoln City apartment community. Apne excels in her studies, consistently receiving A grades, but the recent school book expenses add financial strain. To support the family, Tarak takes up the dangerous job of transporting spinal fluid, earning minimal income. The situation becomes so dire that they can't even afford to buy a few books. Understanding her brother's struggles, Apne decides to quit school.
No.
The next day, Tarak goes to his designated workplace, using the opportunity to showcase his superpowers to his boss, Garrett. Holding a ball, he transforms his hands into a material resembling basketball. Tarak hopes for a higher-paying job.
Just give me a chance to...
Help him up.
To protect his business, Garrett regularly delivers a large sum of money to the community police. Tarak is aware of this, but is unaware of the details of their transactions. One day, disguised as a wolf, Tarak waits for the delivery vehicle. When the vehicle leaves, he follows it to an empty alley. Witnessing the money being thrown into a trash bin and locked, Tarak, armed with an axe, breaks the lock, grabs the bag full of money, and prepares to leave. Just as Tarak reached the corner, a police car approached, forcing him to quickly hide in a pile of garbage. The police officer opened the trash bin, but the money bag was nowhere to be found.
Bag's gone.
Panicking, Tarak hurriedly took off, accidentally leaving his backpack on the ground. The police officer immediately recognized it as Garrett's henchman's specialized bag for transporting drugs and suspected a betrayal within Garrett's ranks. At that moment, the police officer used a flashlight to inspect the surroundings, and Tarak, in a moment of panic, transformed the material of his body into that of the wall. Although his skin changed, his facial features remained visible.
Hey, stop!
Seeing Tarak attempting to escape, Officer Little Black reached for his gun, but was stopped by Chief Kim, who ordered him to use the robotic dog for pursuit. In a state of frenzy, Tarak sought refuge in an abandoned warehouse and barricaded the door from the inside. Tarak, thinking he had successfully evaded capture, gleefully examined the large sum of money in the bag. However, the robotic dog entered the warehouse through another door. Tarak, feeling triumphant, turned around only to be startled by the dog. The noise of the dropped bag caught the attention of the robotic dog. Before the robotic dog descended the stairs, Tarak hid behind a cabinet. Slowly and cautiously, he moved towards the exit, but the warehouse was filled with discarded materials. Tarak transformed into the appearance of clothing, successfully evading the robotic dog's scan. He breathed a sigh of relief. Carrying the money, Tarak walked home, unaware that the robotic dog had been waiting for him there all along. He was immobilized by an electric lock pad shot from the robotic dog. Quickly raising his hands, Tarak took advantage of the robotic dog's feature, which ceased attacking once it detected raised hands. The robotic dog stopped in its tracks, but Chief Kim, fearing exposure of his dealings with the drug dealer, ordered the robotic dog to kill Tarak. The police had equipped it with a lethal dose of SEC injector, injected with the drug. Tarak attempted to transform and escape, only to realize his superpowers had malfunctioned. After a moment of stillness, he succumbed to the effects of the drug. Meanwhile, Tarek's sister, Apne witnessed the scene.
Tarek!
The robotic dog approached her to eliminate any witnesses, but with a simple wave of her hand, Apne disabled the robotic dog. The next day, the police took the malfunctioning robotic dog back to the station for repairs. Upon reviewing the surveillance footage, they discovered Apne was also a superpowered individual with a unique ability. Level 5 electrician Connor, working as a janitor at the community center, discovered a hidden girl in a small warehouse while cleaning. It turned out to be Apne. Connor sought the help of her colleague, Aunt Mina, to console Apne, and eventually gained her trust. However, the police arrived, knowing they were after Apne. Mina instructed Connor to take Apne and leave quickly, while she dealt with the police herself.
Is there someone inside?
Yes, me. Now goodbye.
Connor brought Apne back to his home, but their whereabouts had already been captured by surveillance. Shortly after their arrival, the police arrived and invaded Connor's house. However, Connor had already slipped away. Just as they exited the front door, two mechanical police officers descended from the sky. The appearance of the mechanical police officers signaled the absence of negotiation. As the police officers prepared to shoot, Connor unleashed his superpowers. Although temporarily evading the police pursuit, Connor found himself in a desperate situation. He decided to meet with his former partner, Garrett, hoping he could arrange new identities for them and lead them out of the city overnight. However, Garrett was already aware of Apne's situation. Knowing she possessed a rare and extraordinary ability, Garrett proposed a solution. If Apne could forget everything she had seen the previous night, she could continue to live a peaceful life. In the current circumstances, Garrett's suggestion was undoubtedly the optimal choice. Not long after, they found a memory eraser named Tamala. However, as Apne held Tamala's hand, Tamala's eyes turned black. Without delay, she instructed Apne to recall memories of her and her brother. These memories would then vanish. However, there was more to it. To prevent the memories from resurfacing, they needed to be completely eradicated. In simpler terms, all memories related to her brother, Tarek, had to be removed. This sparked dissatisfaction from Connor, who shouted for Apne to leave, but Apne was already trapped in the memories, unable to break free. Garrett's men intervened, raising a fire barrier to stop Connor from interfering. Seizing the opportunity, Connor used the fire to activate a fire extinguisher, flooding the room with water. He then unleashed his superpowers, stunning Garrett's men. Garrett led Apne to reunite with their colleague, Mina. Mina drove them, intending to escape the city. However, the police were already well aware of their whereabouts. Soon, two mechanical police officers were stationed on their route, ready to eliminate Connor and the others. As they neared their destination, Garrett arrived and intercepted them. Seeing Garrett's presence on the surveillance footage from the mechanical police officers, the police withheld their fire, waiting to see how Garrett would handle the situation.
So much for taking care of your own.
Put me in a fucking corner, Connor!
We have to kill a little girl?
You don't know shit! Everything that I have, I built!
How long before he takes it? Killing us isn't gonna stop what's coming.
After much deliberation, Garrett ultimately decided to lower his weapon. Yet, in the next moment, the police commanded the robots to open fire on them. Worried that Apne might expose what she witnessed, they were determined to eliminate her. In an effort to protect the others, Mina chose to be the bait, drawing the fire towards her. Under Mina's cover, Garrett, Connor, and Apne managed to escape. They drove from day into night until they reached an abandoned house. It was a place where Garrett had once lived. As they entered, tensions flared.
Help with this. Fuck you. I'm not gonna be of much help to you with a bullet in my shoulder.
Who gives a shit? We're here because of you and the people you partnered.
Everything I did for the tower.
Fuck. You did it to get rid.
Get out of my face!
God, get out of my
face! Stop!
They endured a difficult night in the abandoned house, but the following day, Little Mustache, A nemesis of Police Chief Kim managed to locate them. Little Mustache had been seeking ways to bring down Kim. However, since Kim became the chief, crime rates in the city had rapidly decreased, earning him support from various departments and leaders. Attempting to expose him through official channels proved futile. APNE remembered the surveillance capabilities of the mechanical dogs. They recorded everything and shared data among themselves for self-training. Breaking into the police station to capture one of these dogs was impractical. Little Mustache then recalled that Kim had a personal use mechanical dog at home. If they could obtain the dog's head and give it to APNE, she could use her superpowers to extract the stored data, exposing Kim's wrongdoings.
I can do this.
Garrett and Connor, disguised as police officers, entered Kim's home. They restrained Kim in a room while APNE, using her superpowers, unlocked the garage. As expected, they found the charging mechanical dog inside. However, it was secured with a lock. APNE attempted to unlock it, but accidentally activated it, triggering an alarm that sent an alert to the police station. Desperate for a response, the police dialed Kim's home landline. As the house phone rang, Kim's wife went to answer, and Connor, using the excuse of going to the restroom, left. Connor reached the garage and found APNE attempting to unlock the mechanical dog. Despite multiple unsuccessful attempts, APNE, encouraged by Connor, tried once more. Meanwhile, tensions escalated between Garrett and Kim in the house. Suddenly, their discussion turned into a confrontation.
You become one of them!
And Garrett left the house triumphantly. It was only at this moment that Kim realized his mechanical dog had been stolen. However, upon reaching the tower, Garrett and his associates found themselves surrounded by Garrett's men. It turned out that Garrett, he aimed to use the data within the mechanical dog to control Kim. This way, he could alleviate the oppression faced by superpowered individuals from the police. Garrett removed the head of the mechanical dog, handing it over to his men for safekeeping. Shortly after, the police arrived at the tower, encircling the area. Garrett returned the body of the mechanical dog to Kim, using the data in the head as leverage to negotiate a new agreement with the police. However, Garrett underestimated the loyalty and conviction of these police officers.
That's not gonna work for me. You wanna know what power? I don't need to hide. Cops, judges, politicians, the whole fucking system. That's what you never understood.
Kim ordered his men to besiege the tower until they found the mechanical dog's head. Connor witnessed everything happening outside from a window and tried to persuade them to hand over the head. The country's largest television network also arrived on the scene, eager to uncover why the police had sealed off the building. Seeing the reporters gave Connor renewed hope. If they could expose all of Kim's crimes in front of the media, they still had a chance to bring him down. Simultaneously, the mechanical dogs, led by the police, reached the room where Connor and the others were hiding. As Kim's team prepared to attack, Connor unleashed his superpowers. However, the police officers were equipped with specially modified gear, and firemen used the distraction to set a fire, providing cover for the others to escape. Connor, with APNE, entered the corridor but was confronted by several mechanical dogs. Knocked down by the dogs, Connor unleashed unprecedented power. Causing the dogs to short-circuit temporarily. Thinking he had escaped, Connor was shocked when the dogs reactivated, and this time, they injected a lethal dose of sec into him. As the injection neared completion, the mechanical dog suddenly stopped. APNE, using her superpowers, had taken control of the mechanical dog, turning it to face another approaching dog. After defeating the second dog, It went towards the terrified police officers. In a moment of panic, one officer pulled out a gun, and the mechanical dog severed several of his fingers. Unfortunately, a bullet fired during the struggle struck Apne. In critical condition, Apne urged Connor to take her outside. She wanted to expose everything in front of the news reporters. The police ordered the mechanical dogs to attack Connor, but Garrett intervened, using his superpowers to crush the dogs. The police aimed their guns at Garrett, demanding him to release his grip. Just then, Little Beard arrived and intervened, instructing the other officers to step back. With the threat neutralized, reporters approached Apne. Connor used his superpowers to electrify the dog's head. Apne held the dog's head in her left hand and a reporter's camera in her right, using her abilities to transfer the footage from the head to the camera. The national broadcast exposed the crimes committed by Kim using the mechanical dogs. Despite this, Kim remained unyielding and ordered other police officers to shoot at Connor. However, all the officers stood motionless. Frustrated, Kim attempted to take matters into his own hands, only to be controlled by Garrett. Garrett manipulated Kim's gun, pointing it at his own temple. In the end, Kim was successfully arrested. Connor reverted to his life as a janitor, and despite bringing down one Kim, the cycle of corruption seemed unbroken, with new figures emerging continuously. Following Kim's downfall, the synthetic drug SEC continued to proliferate in Lincoln City from unknown sources. Garrett, implicated in SEC trafficking, was also apprehended. The only solace was that amidst the chaos, Apne survived with the support of those around her. Currently, she and Connor depend on each other for survival.